We are a bunch of engineers associated with the engineering school, but we're working with direct collaboration with the medical school and the neurosurgeons and the cardiovascular surgeons. These models, the 3D printing model that we're making, are intended mostly for high-risk patients.
I still remember the case was somebody who had a difficult aneurysm to treat, and the current technology probably would not have been perfect, but there was this new device. Prior to actually performing the procedure, we 3D printed her vessels and deployed the device, and it worked like a charm. And so that gave us the confidence to do the actual operation.
The 3D printed models are starting with 3D imaging. We are recording that 3D imaging, and based on that, we start doing a mathematical model, which is patient specific. These models are unique because they are mimicking, or they are replicating, the artery disease and the mechanical properties of the disease.
This allows you to plan your procedure, try it, make some modifications as you think necessary, and then go a little bit better prepared when you're actually doing the procedures. The next step in all of this is to determine that this technology makes a difference, not just to us for planning the procedure, but to our patients for whom it really is intended.
3D printing overall has passed the part where it's just a hobby or a research tool. It's actually a full-blown medical product.